Learning is a power, knowledge is a weapon. Use these to change yourself and your career too. So for changing your career, let's get started with this concept. So as all of you know, right guys, that we have discussed in the last video about the arrange method of numby array in Python. So today we will be going to discussing further for the append method of array of numby library in Python. As I have said in the last video, that today's content is fully based on the previous content, as well as we are also going to learn some new content in today's video. So be concentrated, because today we are going to learn a concept that is not only used in the array, that also uses in the list concept also. So be concentrated and be prepared for it also. So if you haven't revised about the arrange method till now, so now go and let's revise for the arrange method. So as you, I have done a quick revision for you. So see up this code that we have did in last video. As you will be seeing this, so I guess you will be getting remember that what I have taught in the last video, in the last lecture. So as explaining a little bit, that we have done an arrange method. Arrange method, the usage of this is to providing a range, number of range that will be as an array for your array operations. So you can run this program and check it out, that what will be output you will be getting. Here nothing is important, that you will be pressing only 5 as a range, you can put any other range over there. So it's up to you. Okay, so now we're moving further for the next program, that is append method in Python array programming. So firstly, before starting for the append method in Python array, we will first to know about the meaning of the append. I know that some of you guys also know the meaning of append, and they have also used in the list also. But here we are going to learn about the array. These two are the different concepts but having some similar features. Okay, so let's, and even similar features doesn't mean the similar code. These are having some different type of codes and different type of output over there. So let's get started with the list first. So it will also revise your concept of list that we have studied so far, so months before. So starting with a list only, after that we'll be moving further for the array. Okay, so firstly, what is list? We have to know about this. So anyone of you have known about the meaning of this, so please comment in the comment section. And now we are going to starting with the list. So list are the number of list of any type of data, like int, float, decimal. Okay, even I'm not saying that only type of data or number only, because list is of array strings also. So string is any number of items, you can say here. Okay, so firstly, we have to know that how we have created list, how we are creating list. As I have said, it's something is similar here, but not everything is similar here in the array or in the list. So first, starting with the creation of a list. Okay, so firstly, in the list, how we will create, we have been listing a name of the list, list1, then equals to square brackets, then let's say we are having these kind of numbers over there. 78. Okay, so now this is my list one, list created with the name of list one. Okay, now I'm creating another variable and storing now here you can see that I have also created a list one. Okay, now I am also creating a list name x. Now we are going to print them both, print list one. I'm running it, so you can see here that as list one and x list name, this name X, they both get runs. Now we have to do something else in this code also. So you can see here that the number of elements in this list are same as we have mentioned over there. So now we have to append it. Okay, so first thing is that we have created list. Now the meaning of the append. ओके सो गाइस अपेंड आपकी एक लिस्ट में एक सिंगल आर्ग्यूमेंट को या एलिमेंट को स्पेसिफाइड एलिमेंट को ऐड करता है. ओके सो अपेंड फंक्शन इज यूज फॉर एडिंग एन स्पेसिफाइड एलिमेंट इन योर लिस्ट और इन योर एरे. ठीक है सो बेसिक क्लैरिटी माइंड में ये रखो दैट व्हाई द लिस्ट इज बीइंग यूज्ड बाय द एरे where the append function is used in the list or in the array operations. Okay, so first thing is that ki append jahan bhi naam aata hai, so keep in mind that append ka matlab ye hai ki aapko us particular list mein jo particular ek aap element hai ya array ka element hai aapko usko usme increase karna hai without changing any further values, without disturbing anyone in the array. अगर आपसे ये कहा जाए कि आपको एक रूम में 15 से 20 लोग हैं, आपको उसमें एक पर्सन को और एंट्री दिलानी है बिना किसी को डिस्टर्ब किए, सो हाउ यू विल बी डूइंग दिस. आप जब वो एक पर्सन को एंटर करा रहे हो उस रूम में तो डेफिनेटली उस वहाँ पर्सन जितने 15 लोग थे उसमें से एक बढ़ रहा है, 16 हो रहा है, राइट. तो सेम कॉन्सेप्ट आपको यहाँ इम्प्लीमेंट करना है कि आपके पास अगर एक आपके एरे या आपके एक लिस्ट में 5 एलिमेंट्स हैं, अगर आप एक को अपेंड करा रहे हो यूजिंग अपेंड मेथड, इट मीन्स दैट यू आर एडिंग एन एक्स्ट्रा वैल्यू ओवर देयर. मीन्स आपकी जो लिस्ट की एलिमेंट्स की वैल्यू है या एरे के जो एलिमेंट्स की वैल्यू है वो इंक्रीज हो रही है, राइट. सो आपका यहाँ पे ये मतलब होता है. अभी जैसे आपने इंसर्ट मेथड पढ़ा था एरे में ही, सो इंसर्ट और आपका जो ये अपेंड है दोनों में डिफरेंस ये है कि अपेंड हर जगह यूज़ होता है. अपेंड का आप काफ़ी तरीके से यूज़ कर सकते हो. अभी उसके हम काफ़ी एग्जांपल्स देखेंगे. पहला एग्जांपल हमारा हमारी लिस्ट के साथ देखेंगे अभी हम, फिर दूसरा एग्जांपल हम अपने एरे के साथ देखेंगे, द नेक्स्ट एग्जांपल हम एक और एरे है मीन्स इन अ डिफरेंट वे यूजिंग द ए रेंज मेथड ऑल्सो. सो ये 2-3 वेज हैं हमारे अपेंड को यूज़ करने के, राइट. मैं ऐसा नहीं कह रही कि एक ही मेथड आपका एक तरीके से आप यूज़ कर सकते हो. इट डिपेंड अपॉन यू दैट हाउ यू विल बी गोइंग टू यूज दिस एंड हाउ मच नॉलेज ऑफ यू हैव अबाउट इट. ओके सो फर्स्ट थिंग इज दैट व्हाट वी हैव टू डू दैट वी आर गोइंग टू अपेंडिंग अ लिस्ट राइट नाउ. सो आई गेस एवरीवन इज क्लियर विद द मीनिंग ऑफ द अपेंड एंड व्हाई वी एंड in which condition we have to use the append function in array in an array in any list. Okay, so now starting with example, this moving on to this example for again. So as you can see here that we have been written over there that about the list firstly example, right. Okay, I guess it's clear. So now append function we will be going to use here. How will be using this? Okay, so first name the list name list1 dot append the name of the function and the list appending itself. Now we can see in the example that we are also having, this is your first list, this is your second list. Okay, so now we have to append this list into this list. Now how we can do this? I guess some people will be aware about it, that I have wrote over there about the list 1 dot append, means main list 1 mein hi list 2 जो है एक्स नेम की मैं उसको अपेंड करने वाली हूँ, यानी कि एड ऑन करने वाली हूँ, राइट. आई थिंक इट विल बी वेरी क्लियर टू एवरीवन दैट इन लिस्ट 1 डॉट अपेंड इट डायरेक्टली मींस दैट इन द लिस्ट 1 आई एम अपेंडिंग, आई एम एडिंग द लिस्ट नेम्ड एक्स ओवर देयर. सो व्हाट विल बी हैविंग विल बी राइटिंग हियर एक्स ओनली. सो आई गेस इट्स क्लियर टू यू ऑल दैट लिस्ट 1 डॉट अपेंड एक्स डायरेक्टली मींस दैट लिस्ट 1 in the list 1 we are going to add another list that named is x. Okay, you can also name with list 2 also. Okay, it will be depending for your comfortable. So Now, what we have to do is that we have appended a list. Now, we have to run this. So, just let's look up at the output. Okay. So, I guess everything is done now. Now, we can further move on for the output. So, here you can say that, see that this is your first list. This is your second list. This one is the first list, this one is the second list, and this one is your appended list. What the list? Appended list. This list is the combination of the list 1 and the list X. So you can see that. I hope that the concept of list appending will be clear to you all. Now moving further for the next concept, that appending an array in Python. Array. So we have did list appending. Now we are moving further for the array. So actually there was two ways, that all of you know that we have been done in the last video about using NumPy library. We have imported NumPy library, then we have used the arrange method, and then we have to use now the append method. But we will not going to that method only. We will be first moving forward the only array method. So I hope guys that this list method will be clear to you. So I'm erasing this. So further moving with the next content, that it will be visible to you all guys. Yeah. So now we will be going to starting with array only. So firstly I am going to importing array. Because guys, as you all know that before using any function of any module, we have to import it first. So we have imported the array module. Now I am going to use the making the element x is equals to. Before making this, I wanted to clear first thing that in this, there is a syntax over there that it will be using in whole this code. That one is array dot array. Then within parenthesis we have to write the Unicode, and elements. Now done. So this is the syntax of this program using without using the NumPy library over there. Okay. So firstly, as you can see here, that array.array will be there. So this array is the name of the module, dot array is the name of the function. As you all know that we have been using till now import NumPy as npm, and while we have used this np.arrange, because we have said here as np. So jahan pe bhi hum numpy use karne wale the wahan pe hum numpy ki jagah np likhenge. But in this case of this we haven't mentioned anything over there as or something, humne kuch nahi likha hai. So yahan pe array dot array hi aayega. Okay, if we mention anything over there, then we can write as something, but as not. So we have to write this. So I hope that this part of this syntax will be clear. And now moving for the Unicode in the elements part. So apart from these, I think this part will be clear to you all. So what left is Unicode. So now let's understand it. What is this Unicode? Okay, so let's get to know this. Actually Unicode, this means that the type of the data, the type of the element we are going to mention here. Right, as you know that we having so many type of data, right, like decimal, integer, string, float, long integer, and something else. So firstly we have to mention the type of the data, type of the number, then we have to mention the element. So let's see it with an example. I hope that it's clear to you, that because it's a very simple concept, right? You have just to mention a type of an element and an element name, right? Just done. So now let's moving for this. So firstly I'm going to create an element, sorry, a variable with name of x equals to array dot array, then यहाँ पर हमें यूनिकोड लिखना है. सो आई एम मेंशनिंग द इंटीजर बेस नंबर एलिमेंट ओवर देयर देन कॉमा, देन आई एम राइटिंग द एलिमेंट्स ओवर देयर, मीन्स आई एम क्रिएटिंग एन एरे ओवर हियर. सो व्हाट वाज द एरे दैट वी कैन सी हियर. ओके, सो वी हैव बीन डन विद इट. सो आई होप माय फिफ्थ लाइन इज करेक्ट. गाइस चेक इट, दिस करेक्ट और नॉट, लेट मी नो इन द कमेंट सेक्शन. Okay, I guess it's correct. Now let's see in the output. So this is a name variable we have created with the name of x. Now we are going to create a variable, another variable with the name of a y, and is storing a value y is equals to name of any element name number, like we have mentioned 62. Okay, so now we have two elements over there, two variables over there, x and y. Now we have to append these. As you can see in the list, we have appended list 1 dot append x. हमने लिखा था parentheses के अंदर में. Similar thing is will be happening here only. Okay? But dissimilar is what? We haven't imported any library for this. But now in array, we have to import an input array module in doing this. So, I think you will be getting here that list and array are not too much similar. They are too much similar, but not exactly the same thing. So now let's moving for this example over. So x dot append y. Okay. So we can say here from this code that in the line number 7, we will be appending x name list and adding the value of a y. मीन्स अभी हमारे पास जो भी हमारे एलिमेंट्स हैं 34, 77 और 70, अब वहाँ पे एक और वैल्यू ऑर्डर होने वाला है, वो है 62, बिकॉज हम उसे अपेंड कर रहे हैं. तो हम एक्स लिस्ट में अपेंड कर रहे हैं वाई लिस्ट को. नाउ लेट्स सी व्हाट इट विल बी प्रिंटिंग. सो लेट्स प्रिंट एक्स एंड लुक फॉर द आउटपुट. सो हियर वी हैव डन 34, 77, 70 and 62, एज यू कैन सी इन द आउटपुट दैट वी हैव डन विद द अपेंडिंग. So this is our new element that has appended with using this code. So I hope guys that this concept is clear to you all, that how we can append in any import array by using import array. So now we will moving further for the next. As I have said that in the last video, that in today's video we will be moving further. Next concept that we have read in the last video, right? So we have you studied about the np.range arrange method, right? Because you can say it's range only, so range method. So now what we have to do in this, firstly we are going to erase all these because it is getting too much space. Okay, so now moving for this. So firstly we have to look upon importing the numpy library, import numpy as np. Okay, so we have drawn with the importation of a numpy library. Now what we have to do is x is equals to, now this process is somehow same with this only, as you can see here. So I'm just copying this. Okay, let's ignore it. We will be writing here only. So np.arrange, then we have to give a range, number of range over there. So first hum dete hain 5 range. Okay, as from the last example. Now we have been taking another variable over there. Actually us aap x y nahi denge because humara x y to pehle use ho chuka hai. So we will be taking a and then b, then np dot range. Now we will be mentioning over here about the range. Yeah, so you can see here that in the ninth line I have just mentioned one integer name, that is 5. So 0 to 5 elements will be there, means 0 to 4. So now in the second in the 10th line, you can see here that b is equals to n period to range 10, 20. So the range from the 10 to 20 will be there in the example. So now I'm going to appending these two. Now as you can see that we have created two integers or two array type, and then we have appended this and attending or connecting with the meter. So now implementing all those things here only. So here a range method is used for you to just give a range, number of range, and your array will be created and automatically append action will be done there. So for the append action, what we have to do is now R we will be using for the result. RES is equals to that np dot append then x comma y. Now done. अभी हमने यहाँ पे लिख दिया है x comma y, means अब append action हमारा x comma y इन दोनों में ही append होगा, यानी कि इन दोनों में ही ये दोनों values जो हैं एक दूसरे से concat हो जाएंगी. Now I'm just printing this. Okay, so I hope guys that this concept is very much clear to you all, that till the code we have done now. So now we are running it to look up the output. So you can see here 34 34 77 70 62 and 62, again these options have been done again. Okay, just look upon it. Yeah, we have skipped one thing guys, that we have to mention something over here, that print to showcase that this is our number of. Yeah. Array. Comma. B. Guys, देखो यहाँ पे ना जो हमने A और B लिखा है, इसका तो मतलब ये है कि आपका जो भी ए रेंज में जो भी आपके इंटीरियर्स आएंगे 0 to 5 वहाँ पे प्रिंट होके आएंगे, और यहाँ पे आपके बी वाले आएंगे, उसके बाद जो इसका आउटपुट है वो आएगा. ओके गाइस, सो एनीवन कैन सजेस्ट मी द मिस्टेक दैट आई हैव डन हियर, एज वी कैन सी हियर मिस्टेक. इफ एनीवन गेटिंग टू नो दैट व्हाट मिस्टेक आई हैव डन, व्हाई माय आउटपुट इज नॉट अप टू द मार्क बट इट इज ऑल्सो नॉट शोइंग मी एरर. ओके, सो जस्ट लेट अस ऑन इट. Yeah, so guys, as you can see here that I have appended x comma y, okay? In the last line you will be seeing that this is the code that I have used. This is our first array x, this is our second array y, means it is implemented. This is the one that we have concatenated. So the last array 34 77 70 62 62 is the output of this one that I have written over here. This is equals to np dot append x comma y, means what should be here, a comma b. So we will be getting a correct output of this. In the previous output we can see that this array is not appended, only the result of the A and B will be there. Just see that again. Yeah. So here you can see very clearly about this, that this is the output that first we have done with the only importing array, right? And this one is the first range 0 to 5 that I have mentioned, I've given it using A range method 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. And this is a range of 10 to 20 range. Okay, so you can see here that the range of range function worked properly for A and B array. But here there is nothing append functions have performed their operations. Why? And you can see here that here 2 times 62 is there. 2 times 62 is there. So what's the mistake? Anyone of you can guess it? Then please comment in the comment section. Otherwise we'll move forward with it. So 62, it means that as you can careful, as you have if seen in the code carefully, that in the last line I have written over there, res is equals to np dot append x comma y. मैंने x comma y लिखा था, means जो मेरे पास जो मेरा array है x और y, जो मेरा पहले import array हमने module में लिखा था, वो array जो है, वो array यहाँ पे इसमें अपेंड होके यहाँ पे शो हो गया. एक्चुअली शो किसको होना चाहिए था, जो एरे 0 है, 0 1 2 3 4 0 10 11 12 13 14 15 16 17 18 19, इन्हें होना चाहिए था, बट अनफॉर्चुनेटली वो हो गया बाय द मिस्टेक. सो नाउ लेट्स वी हैव टू इम्प्रूव इट एंड लेट्स सी द ओरिजिनल आउटपुट ऑफ दिस. सो हियर यू गॉट 0 टू 19. Everything is now appended. So now your result will be very clear. This is the first appended list. Import array we have used. This is the first 0 to 5 range. This is our 0 to 10 to 20 range. And this is our appended array range. So I guess guys that this concept will be clear to you, that we have did today how we can use append function in three different ways. In the list, in the import array only, and with the using of the NumPy module only. So I hope that if you have any doubt, then you can ask me a question regarding this, and if you have any query about this, then you can ask also. And if you think that anything is wrong there, then you can also comment me and suggest me the perfect solution for this also. So that's it for today. I think it's very much. So I hope that you will like the content. It content will be useful for you. So moving ahead with the next content in the next coming video. So bye bye and take care guys.